Amazing. It's like a holes in the sky. People cry. People laugh. You don't know if that hole's going to swallow you up.
Excitement was high in Exmouth as tens of thousands of tourists poured in to feast their eyes on the big attraction. Not that big attraction. Eclipse chasers from all over the world flocking to the remote town in northwest WA. One of the only places in the world to experience a total solar eclipse, Exmouth attracted only the most enthusiastic fans.
I've seen 17 this far. I started in 1999.
Saved $5,000 working at Macca's past 6 months to come out here.
While some have historically struggled to follow eclipse safety protocol, these guys had their very fetching glasses on hand, and when the time came, they weren't disappointed.
Just surreal, and I've seen one before. Even though this was shorter, the Bailey's beads and the solitude and the beauty of it, oh, I'll never forget this eclipse.
So I kind of feel like electrical charges going through.
We travelled 17,000 kilometres for this eclipse, and for me, this is number 18.
The particularly rare hybrid eclipse, where the moon completely covers the sun with a smaller solar ring visible around the moon, stunning spectators.
And, you know, things got darker beforehand, and then it looks like nothing else in the sky there.
And there was a big cheer.
Yeah, there was a cheer.
Well, joining us from Exmouth is former astronaut Tim Peake. Tim, we saw a lot of people getting really emotional watching this eclipse. How did you feel?
Yeah, it was incredible, a very surreal experience, a very eerie experience. Some people found it very spiritual. Everything went very, very quiet and very cool. Of course, darkness came and we saw the stars and we saw planets. It was the most unusual situation, something that you really have to be here to experience, but incredible.
Tim, why is it so special? I mean, you've been to space, so were you impressed by it all? Because surely space is way more impressive than a bit of darkness during the day.
Space is incredible. Space is very impressive, especially to look down on the planet. I actually got to see an eclipse from space. So I got to see the shadow of the moon falling on planet Earth from the space station, which was brilliant. But to actually be here and to feel it happening to you as the moon blocks out the sun, it really was quite remarkable. And it was much more than I was anticipating, actually. I kind of just thought, oh, it's going to get dark for a little bit. But the speed at which it happens and then the coolness, the wind drops, all the birds go back to the trees. It really is a very, very strange situation.
You said that it went very quiet. Was there anyone trying to commentate as it was going on, their feelings or what you're all watching?
Oh, yeah, I mean, the nature goes quiet and very still, but some people were cheering. I mean, there was a lot of emotion. Some people were hugging. I mean, everybody kind of reacts in their own different way to this. I think if you wanted to watch it in peace and quiet, then, you know, you'd go away from the crowds. But I actually really enjoyed being here in Exmouth. I enjoyed the crowds. I thought to get that human reaction to the eclipse was very special.
Tim, is there something about the speed of it? So, like, I'm trying to figure out what's so special about this. Is it something about it's day, then it's night very briefly, and then it's day again, and it all happens in a rush?
Yeah, it kind of creeps up on you. What you have to appreciate is just how powerful our sun is. It's so powerful that even when there's only a tiny of sliver of sun there, it's still bright enough to make you not really appreciate that we're even going into eclipse. So as the moon kind of shuts off that tiny last sliver of light, it happens very quickly. And that's what I think we all found surprising. We knew it was coming. We'd been watching it for over an hour slowly creep its way across the sun. But it was that last 2 minutes where somebody just turned off the lights very quickly. And I think that's what was so spooky.
As we mentioned, you've been to space. So does seeing something like this just make you want to pack your bags and jump back on a rocket and head to the moon?
I've been wanting to jump back on a rocket ever since I got back to Earth. I mean, just being in space is such a special experience. You know, the view of Earth, the feeling of weightlessness, you can't beat it. So I think if you speak to any astronaut, they'll tell you they're ready to go back up.
Tim, before you go, I do have a question for you. I was thinking about this today. When you're at a dinner party, is it kind of annoying because when people are talking about their day and things going on in their life, you're like, guys, this is boring. I've been to space.
I quite enjoy having a break talking from space as much as I love it. So if I'm at a dinner party and we're not talking about space, that's fine by me. But no, I'm passionate about it. So if people want to talk about space, that's great.
Sam relates because he went to Bali once and he loves talking about it.
It's crazy over there. It's so different to where I'm from, you know. It's just,
Well, I love that you've been able to talk to us about space once again, Tim. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much. It's been great talking to you.
Oh, you came back different from Bali.
I know,
you really
it was
did.
Crazy. I'll always remember the rush.